100 years, Universal has made some of the most beloved and critically acclaimed films to ever come out of Hollywood. Time and again, these films were heralded by the Academy Awards for taking chances.
Okay, guys, we're going to the moon.
And changing the way audiences look at the world.
In the name of God, do your duty.
Universal's films have given actors the roles of a lifetime.
There's been some high talk around town to the effect that I shouldn't do much about defending this man.
If you shouldn't be defending him, then why are you doing it?
If I didn't, I couldn't hold my head up in town.
Gregory Peck won the Academy Award for Best Actor in To Kill a Mockingbird, playing Atticus Finch.
The defendant is not guilty. But somebody in this courtroom is.
A small-town lawyer who stood up to intolerance with passion and conviction.
And now, folks, we've got a special treat for you. Miss Loretta Lynn.
For Coal Miner's Daughter, Loretta Lynn herself handpicked Sissy Spacek to portray the country artist.
Are you and Daddy going out again tonight, Mama?
Yes, honey, I'm about to swing over in Lynn.
Can I go with you?
Oh, no, that's a rough old honky-tonk. You can't be going over there.
And the young star surprised the world, singing the songs herself and transforming from an unworldly 13-year-old to a middle-aged singer on the verge of a breakdown. Miss Spacek took home the award for Best Actress.
That was the last song in the book, Ray.
You know, Fathead, it ain't never the last song. Now, band, follow me, do what I do, say what I say. This is how we're gonna do it.
Jamie Foxx poured everything into Ray, wearing eye prosthetics 14 hours a day and practicing piano late into the night, all in the hopes of capturing the great R&B singer.
I hear like you see, like that hummingbird outside the window, for instance.
Uh-oh.
You hear that?
What?
A heart just skipped a beat.
The film won 2 Academy Awards, including Best Actor.
Here he is. Here's your chance, heroes. For the fatherland.
Universal's films have also taken home the biggest prize, the Oscar for Best Picture. In 1930, All Quiet on the Western Front showed the nightmare of the trenches, revealing the ravages of war from the German side, underscoring the message that war is hell for all involved.
We didn't want it. The English didn't want it. And here we are fighting.
It was a difficult film and a big one. The production was riddled with cost overruns and before release, often ridiculed by the Hollywood community. But the film stunned critics to silence and is often referred to as the greatest anti-war movie ever made.
We are here today to tell you a little bit about the Marine Corps.
Universal has repeatedly taken an uncompromising look at war. Oliver Stone won Best Director for taking audiences to Vietnam in Bourne on the 4th of July.
I want to go to Vietnam, and I'll die there if I have to.
This powerful movie starred Tom Cruise as an eager Marine who was left a paraplegic on the battlefield, but who found a second act as an anti-war and human rights activist. Steven Spielberg delivered the most sobering war story of them all, his heartbreaking masterpiece about the Holocaust, Schindler's List.
What's a person worth?
No. What's one worth to you?
Soldinger Ernestina, Welt der grünen Hinder.
Willing to be beholden only to his conscience, Spielberg took on the film with a limited budget and shot it, stripping away every camera trick in his arsenal. He delivered his most austere film and also his most powerful.
I didn't do enough.
You did so much.
The movie took home 7 Oscars, including Best Picture and Best Director.
He's not as tough as he thinks.
Neither are we.
But Universal has been winning Best Picture awards for more than just war films. Sometimes, the thing audiences crave most is escape. Universal offered the ultimate escapist film, The Sting, a perfect sleight of hand, balancing the chemistry of Paul Newman and Robert Redford with a lightning-quick story about con artists pulling off the big con.
That's it, fellas.
It took home 7 Oscars, including Best Picture.
Where will he land?
Trick is not to.
Sometimes, Universal's films offered escape to places one could only imagine. Sidney Pollack took audiences to the far reaches of Kenya with the epic drama Out of Africa, winning 7 Academy Awards, including Best Picture and Best Director. Audiences and critics alike were swept away in the extraordinary love affair between Meryl Streep and Robert Redford. Universal's films have also been recognized for the extraordinary efforts of the crew behind the scenes who help make audiences believe in the impossible. With groundbreaking special effects, they've fallen in love with an alien.
Look out!
Shuddered at a rampaging dinosaur. Cheered for a gallant pig.
Oh, beautifully done.
And cried for a lovesick ape. They've shown a window on a place and a time with a stunning look, pitch-perfect costumes, and a whole world created. They've drawn audiences into their story with riveting drama and pulse-pounding excitement. They showed that an actor could be transformed in prosthetics and still move audiences beneath the pounds of makeup. Universal's films have made audiences hear the world in a whole new way.
Houston, we have a problem.
For 100 years, these are the stories that have moved audiences and swept them away, reminding them that the beating heart on screen reflects their own.